In this video, I show you how to reduce the volume of your audio clips in Shotcut. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at audio in Shotcut and more specifically, how to manage your audio volumes in your Shotcut projects. So to start this demonstration, I have created a simple project and I've got two video channels and one audio channel. The only video that has audio attached to it is on the very end, and these other three clips do not have any audio attached. The audio for them is in the audio channel underneath. So to demonstrate the audio quickly, I'm just going to click play. And as you can tell, it's quite loud. It's slightly overpowering for what I want the video to be doing. So what I need to do is lower the audio volume of that clip. Now there are two ways to do this. The first is to simply select the clip, go up to your filters, click on the plus, and then on your audio filters, search for gain. The gain and volume filter will pop up, click into it, and then on this level here, you can just, if you want it to lower, you make it to say a minus number. And if you want it to increase, you make it a plus number. You can also select the exact number you want by typing in the box. That will now play at a slightly reduced volume because I've set mine to minus 9. Let's just give that a try. Okay, so I'm happy with that. That's great. That's exactly what I wanted my video to sound like. You will obviously have different preferences for your video and you can tweak them as much as you need to. The only thing I would say when you're modifying your audio is to use a pair of headphones and not standalone speakers that could otherwise pick up other noises around the room and make it sound a little bit different to what it actually is. It's quite a well-known tip that in the audio industry, you would always use a pair of noise-cancelling earphones that go right over the ear, so it blocks out external sounds, thus producing the best work. Now, towards the end of the project here, we have a different scenario, and this scenario is that we have two audio tracks playing at the same time, and they're going to kind of drown each other out. They're not really going to sound as we want them to. So in my case, I want to select one or the other to use and not have both playing. You could want either one in your project, so I'll go over both options right now. And when you're looking to work with the audio and not the video, I suggest taking all of the audio that's built into any video tracks and putting them into their own audio tracks, so then you can work with them separately. You can, there's nothing stopping you working with them in the video, but it can get complicated, and to me, it makes it a lot cleaner, a lot nicer project if you actually separate them out, so all of your audios in your audio channels and all your videos are in your video channels. So the best way to do that is to click onto your video track that has your audio built in, right click, more, detach audio. What that will do is it will put the audio into a new audio track, or if this audio had stopped for any reason and there was space to put it in audio one, then it would go into the first available one, which in my case would be audio one, but there's something there, so it goes into audio two. Now, if you didn't want the sound to play from the bicycle clip, all you need to do now is select it and hit the delete button. That's now removed the sound from this clip, but not your audio track. I'm going to undo that. Now let's cover the other scenario where we actually wanted the audio from the bicycle and not the long audio track. If I zoom in just a little bit, we can see this a little bit better. And there's two ways to address this. Because it's at the very end, you could just simply select this here, click and drag all the way back to where the bicycle starts, and now you know that that audio will stop and the next audio from the bicycle will play. You can also move the bicycle in to the same audio track so you know you're working all within the same audio. There's also the scenario where the bicycle is not at the end of the video, it's actually in the middle and you need to cut it out and put it in. So let me just undo that, put it back to where we were at the start. To do that, in your timeline, select somewhere just before where you want to cut and then click this one here, which will zoom you to the next point, which is in this case where the audio should start. Select the audio you want to remove and then click the split button. If it's in the middle, you'd also need to do that at the end. On my example, it is already at the end, so there's nothing after it. But if you did need to cut this bit out, then also do the same again at the end. Now you can select this part of the clip without selecting any of the other parts. You can delete that, and then same solution, you can move that up. So you end up with the same result, two different ways of doing it. Now, when two audios come together from different sources, you can quite often get a different sound or a different volume. There are tools in Shotcut that will help you make them sound the same. However, I'm only going to focus on the volume audio levels in this tutorial. So as we can see in the first track on the audio channel, it's a lot higher than on the second track in the same audio channel. That means that the first one is going to be louder than the second one. That will leave a bit of a gap in the user's experience when they are listening to your video. So generally speaking, you want to choose if you want to raise one up or lower the other one, or a combination of the two. So what I'm going to do here is we've already lowered this by 9, and I'm just going to raise this one by clicking on the filter, the plus, searching the audio for gain, clicking on gain and volume, and then I'm just going to raise that up a little bit. The actual audio channels will not differ, so you won't see any changes at this stage. So this isn't going to raise up and look like it's the same volume, it's just going to stay the same. But we do know what we've done is raised it by a couple of decibels, and that should, with the combination of lowering this one and rising this one, make them sound about the same. As every project will be different, I can't tell you the exact numbers that you're going to need. You'll just have to play around with them. What I would say is you're probably looking, in most circumstances, around the 0 to 10 kind of change mark. Now let's have a little listen. Yeah, so I'm quite happy with that. It sounds like the audio actually flows and it's roughly the same volume. You may find you need to tweak yours backwards and forwards a little bit, but ultimately that's the process that you go through just to get them equal leveled. Now, before you finish, helpful tip that you might like to know is that if you are actually recording from one audio channel and your whole audio needs to be increased or decreased all at the same time, then you can, in your audio channel, come over here, select the audio, and then apply the gain filter to the whole channel. So what this will do, I'm going to leave it at 0, I'm not going to actually apply it, but what this would do is apply it to every clip in the thing. So you don't need to go into each one, changing up, changing down, changing up, changing down. If you've got some clips that you know you need to go up and some clips that you need to go down, you could actually leave them in two different audio channels, apply down to all of these ones and up to all of these ones, and then when you're playing it, it will filter through correctly. The other thing worth noting is that transitions can work exactly the same as with videos. So if you were to have the same audio on the same track, you could have it fade over so it's less noticeable. Thanks very much for watching. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.